Hey, welcome to another video in our TypeScript narrowing series. In this video, I'll explain type predicates, how to create your own guards, and how to create a guard by exclusion. This is the third video of our series. If you haven't watched the previous ones, I highly recommend that you do. They lay out solid fundamentals for narrowing. I'll leave a link for them in the description. I'm Lucas Paganini, and in this channel, we release web development tutorials. If that's something you're interested in, leave a like and subscribe to the channel. In the last video, we explored the fundamental type guard operators. Now I'd like to show you type guard functions. For example, if you need to check if a variable called value is a string, you could use the type of operator. But what you could also do is create a function called isString that receives an argument and returns true if the given argument is a string. Remember our format error message function from the last video? Let's remove the type of operator from it and use isString instead. It's the same code. We just isolated the guard in a function, right? No, it breaks. TypeScript is not narrowing the type to string. The guard is not working. Here's the thing. isString is returning a boolean, and we know what that boolean means. It means that the argument is a string. But TypeScript doesn't know what the boolean means, so we need to tell it. Instead of saying that our function returns a boolean, we need to say that our function returns the answer to the question, is this argument a string? Given that the name of our argument is value, we do that with the following syntax, value is string. Now TypeScript understands that isString is a type guard, and our format error message function compiles correctly. The return type of our isString function is not just a boolean anymore, it is a type predicate. So, to make a custom type guard, you just need to define a function that returns a type predicate. All type predicates take the form of parameter is type. A quick tip before we continue. Instead of using the type any in our custom guard parameter, our code would be much safer if we used the unknown type. I made a 1-minute video explaining the differences between any and unknown. The link is in the description. Let's exercise our knowledge by converting all the checks in our format error message function to custom guards. We already have a guard for strings. Now we need guards for warning, error, and falsy types. The guard for error is pretty straightforward. We just isolate the instance of operator check in a function. But the warning guard, on the other hand, is not that simple. TypeScript allowed us to use the in operator because there was a limited amount of types that our value parameter could be, and they were all objects. But if we create a function and say that our parameter is unknown, then it could be anything, including primitive types, and that would throw an error because we can only use the in operator in objects. The solution is to make sure our parameter is a valid object before using the in operator, and we also need to make sure that it's not null. For the falsy values guard, we first need to define a type with values that are considered falsy. I'm not including NaN here because there is no NaN type in TypeScript. The type of NaN is number, and not all numbers are falsy, so that's why we're not dealing with NaN. There is a proposal to add NaN as a type, and also integer, float, and infinity. I think that is really nice. It would be very helpful to have those types. I'll leave a link for the proposal in the description. Go give it a thumbs up if you think we should have the NaN type in TypeScript. Anyways, now that we have our falsy type, we can create a falsy values guard. Remember, a value is falsy if it's considered false when converted to a boolean. So, to check if our value is falsy, we can use abstract equality to see if it gets converted to false. That's it. We now have all the custom guards that we need for our format error message function. Before we wrap this up, I want to show you something. There is a limited list of falsy values, right? But truthy values, on the other hand, are infinity. All values that are not falsy are truthy. So, how would you make a type guard for truthy values? The trick is to exclude the falsy types. Instead of checking if our value is truthy, we check that it's not falsy. I use this trick a lot, and we will see it again in future videos. References and other links are in the description. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and follow us on social media. This helps us grow, which results in more free content to you. It's a win-win. And if your company is looking for remote web developers, me and my team are currently available for new projects. You can contact us on lucaspaganini.com. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon.